Good morning, hardworking and wonderful caregivers. I am Carol Howell with Let's Talk Dementia Live, and I'm glad that you've chosen to join me today, wherever you might be reaching us, whether it is on Facebook or Roku or Amazon Fire Stick or YouTube or the website or wherever. Thank you for being here. I am an internationally certified dementia practitioner and Amazon best-selling author of several books that you need. Yeah, you can go to Amazon and find them or go to our website, letstalkdementia.org, and find them there. We are a faith-based not-for-profit. Well, the first book I want to show you is Let's Talk Dementia. It is a caregiver's guide giving you good tips to make caregiving easier. It's got a little bit of humor in there that the Southern girl finds funny. And then also Reminisce and Worship, which is a 90-day devotional that your individual with dementia can work through on their own, or you can sit down and work through it with them. It has beautiful pictures. And then a scripture and questions that you can use to work with your loved one. Check them out. And I hope you enjoy them. Well, I told you yesterday I was going to go get my hair cut and a new beautician to see how it went. Well, I'm kind of pleased. I think it looks good. Somebody's already written in that they like my hair, and I'm pleased, and she was affordable. Man, getting your hair cut down here is expensive. A couple of places I called wanted $67 to wash and trim my short hair. Guess what ain't happening? Well, it was that. So I'm pleased. But today, I want to thank our sponsors for today's show, and that would be HD Imports, located on Flint Street Extension in beautiful Rock Hill, South Carolina. They repair and maintain Honda, Hyundai, Acura, Toyota, and Kia. If you are anywhere nearby, or even if you might need to drive a little distance, they are worth it for the money you're going to save and the assurance of knowing they're taking excellent care of your car. And tell them Carol sent you, would you please? And then also Beth Crosby, EditorBeth.com. Well, Editor Beth is rocking my world, helping making sure that what I produce in the written form is as good as it can be. And I'm learning that the rules of grammar change. Now that just irritates me to no end. You know, you spend all this time when you're in school memorizing all these rules of grammar and punctuation so that when you grow up and become a big girl and you write, that it looks right and it makes sense and people understand it. And then they go change the rules. That's just not right. Alas, it's true. And thankfully, Beth keeps up on those rules because I sure don't. And then I argue with her about them. Only me would argue with the professional. But give her, you can check her out at editorbeth.com and reach her through her website. So this morning, I wanted to talk with you about napping. Are you, you know, Uncle Jed used to ask Jethro on the Beverly Hillbillies, boy, are you for it? Or, no, is you for it or is you again it? In case you were wanting to know, the house that they recorded the Beverly Hillbillies in, an actual house, it wasn't a set, that whole house is for sale, and I'm thinking about making a bid on it. I forget how many millions, or as Uncle Jed said, millions and millions it is. It's a huge amount of money. But is you for it or is you again it? Well, I'm for taking naps. What do you think? I've never been a good napper. It's just not something my body will allow me to do. But napping does become important when we have dementia. Now, I am all for keeping your loved ones going from one activity to the other, to the other, to the other, to lunch, to another activity, to another, to another, to another, to dinner, and then maybe one activity in bed. This is great, if that's what they want to do. And there are people who need that constant movement, that constant attention, that constant interaction. And then there are people who do need naps. Now that may be dependent upon their personality for sure and what they're used to doing, but it also can be very dependent upon where in the process of their disease that they are. See, someone's writing me, when I was little, my mom said I didn't have to go to sleep, but I did have to lie down and rest, and that's still a good idea. It's a very good idea. That was from Editor Beth wrote that. It's a very good idea. But with our folks with dementia, they especially do need rest. Now, if you think your loved one in the last stages doesn't need a nap, Yeah, Mike would kind of wonder about that. And I don't know your loved one. Potentially that's possible. But the reason that your loved one's going to very likely need a nap as we enter those, the late stages or begin to enter that time of life is with dementia, especially Alzheimer's type dementia, we are burning calories at twice the rate that we are if we did not have that disease. Now, I am always all for burning off some of those daggone calories. I was walking the treadmill yesterday. I hate doing that, but it'd been raining, so we did the treadmill. And it tells you how many calories you burn. Squat diddly doo dah for all the work I'd put into it. But when you have Alzheimer's type dementia, you burn that twice as much doing the exact same thing as the person next to you who does not have dementia. Isn't that interesting? So because of that, well, you're going to get tired more quickly. And another reason that folks with dementia potentially are more tired is maybe they're not eating as well as they should be. Maybe their nutrition level isn't what it should be. And then the brain is just not sending those signals to the body the way that you want it to for the whole body to cooperate. You got to also think that our folks with dementia lots of times are not sleeping well at night. So they are more tired just because they didn't sleep well. So we got to allow our folks time to take a nap if they want to take a nap. Now, if you think that you're gonna lie your loved one down for a nap and say, okay, Granny, it's time to take a nap, come on, let's go to bed, and her do that because you want her to, well, that's probably not gonna work either. It's gotta be something she wants to do. So if she's fighting you, she doesn't wanna take a nap, then you need to have plan B up your sleeve where you can go ahead and say, well, okay, let's get up and have a snack then. Snacks are always a good idea. I'm all for good, healthy snacks. Sometimes with my folks with dementia, I'm for just whatever snacks bring peace and calm into their world at that time. And it may not always be carrots and celery, I'm just going to tell you. So keep a thought on that. But realizing that resting is good for your loved one with dementia. I can tell you my mama, on the flip side of that, would have stayed in the bed 24/7. Now, as much as she might would have liked to do that, I can assure you that was not good for her. So the staff was always encouraging her to get up and do this or go to that activity or at least to go down and watch them play ball with the noodles, or you know, even if she didn't want to participate, you get mama down there, she would generally participate. But there are just some folks, they're just not going to do that. And you know, and if that's who they are, that's okay. I think I may have mentioned to you last week about my brother-in-law. He's in an assisted living here in town and doing so well, and we're so very excited. And he just could not possibly care less about activities. I mean, there's just no desire, period, for any activity on the planet. They could be passing out $50 bills just outside his room. He would not get up for it. Well, that's what he wants. That's where he is in his world. That's what makes him happy. So we just go with it because, you know, you can't change it. I've often said that when I grow up one day, I want to be Sophia Petrilla off of Golden Girls. You guys remember that television show? Well, I very much remember it because I still watch it. You know, when I just need a pick-me-up, I watch Sophia Petrilla. And she was the oldest of the Golden Girls. And she could say what she wanted and do what she wanted, and she didn't care. It was okay. If you didn't like it, it did not make a hill of beans difference to her. And I've always said, I want to be Sophia Petrilla, because if I say what I want to say now, I get in trouble all the time about it, and it would be nice not to get in trouble like Sophia. Well, I think about that, you know, you get to the point in your life where you should be able to do what you want and lead life to at least a certain degree the way you want. And if you can't do that when you're a senior citizen, then when the heck is it you get to do it? I don't know. So be aware of that when you're working with your loved ones with dementia. It's not all about what you want to do. Yeah, you need to have plans and you need to have an agenda, so to speak, or an outline for the day where you kind of got things planned and you know what you're going to do. Well, you think you know, it's going to change. But at least you've got options lined up, things that can happen that will work good with your loved one. But realize they're going to throw a little change into your world. What is it? A kink in? Well, I think I can't think of the phrase. But anyway, they're going to change things up on you. You can absolutely bet on that. And if one of those things they want to do is take a nap, maybe let's allow that to happen and not fight it so. But one of the good things you can do when your loved one does lie down for resting is to put those earphones on and allow them to listen to the music that they love. It can be soothing. It can be good for them. They may not go to sleep, but they may lie there and really enjoy that music. And that's good for the brain. They're going to come out of that experience happier people because you gave them the music they like. I just can't tell you guys too many times or stress too strongly how important music is in the world of your folks with dementia. Study after study after study. Oh, my word, proves it. Music is important in your world. When you're having a rough day, put those headphones on your head and listen to your favorite music. Yeah, that's important. Right now, in my world, Michael and I are thinking about the group Alabama because we liked Alabama, still do, but they were part of our dating years, and we're going to see them in September. Yay! I like some Alabama. Just do. It's my kind of music. Well, I hope that gives you something to think about, and I hope that maybe if your LO takes a nap this afternoon, maybe you get to take one. You know, whatever it is you need to do, put it on the back burner and go take a nap yourself. Might be good for you. I know it'd be good for you. You should try it. It might be good for me too, but I probably won't go to sleep. A special thanks to our sponsors who help finance our ministry, and that would be Beth Crosby at editorbeth.com. Check her out for anything that you might be writing. She can put her eyeballs on it and make sure you represent yourself the best way possible. HD Imports, located on Flint Street Extension in Rock Hill, 803-985-0985. And tell these folks that Carol sent you, would you? And check us out on Amazon.com and at our website. Also, our podcast called Let's Talk Dementia, you can find it at Listen Notes, Player.fm, Google Podcasts, iHeartRadio, Podbean, iTunes, Spotify, and our website. Oh yeah, just to name a few places. And we're glad that you join us wherever we might be. And when you go to the website, there will be links to everything we do, including our books. And if you're so inclined, we sure would appreciate a donation to help keep our ministry going. And you can donate right there on the website through PayPal. I hope you have a great day. Tomorrow, let me get my list here. Miss Editor Beth had me compose. I did think she was crazy when she told me to do this, but you know what? It's been really good for me. Let's see. Tomorrow, shopping can be a challenge. That's what we're going to talk about, shopping. You for it or you again it? It's just going to depend on the day for me. See you tomorrow. 8 o'clock, I'll tell you what I'm thankful for. And 8:15, we'll be right here for Let's Talk Dementia. Have a good day. Bye-bye.